Getting from A to B can be a relatively trivial matter in the 21st century, but migrating humans tens of thousands of years ago would not have had it so easy. Professor Kaifu from the University Museum and his colleagues have been exploring ancient migrations to the islands of Japan. It has long been known that Paleolithic people from what is now called Taiwan found their way to the Ryukyu Islands in southwestern Japan, which includes Okinawa. The leading theory has been that these travellers found their way largely by chance. However, Kaifu and his team believe these ancient voyages were intentional. Researchers used 138 satellite-tracked sensors to trace the path of a would-be drifter caught on the Kuroshio current between the land masses. Most of the sensors did not reach their destination, meaning that to get there required an act of intentional navigation. The team also built replica craft to test their ideas and have been steadily building evidence that the ancient populations in question were not passive drifters, but active explorers. At the heart of most galaxies, including our own, lies a massive black hole. Sometimes galaxies collide, and these collisions can provide vast quantities of matter to fuel black hole activity. But not all collisions are equal. Research associate Yohei Miki from the Information Technology Center and his team suggest that certain collisions can even reduce the activity of massive black holes. If the conditions are just right and two galaxies collide head-on, the incoming smaller galaxy can actually clear the matter from around the larger galaxy's black hole. This would starve the massive black hole and reduce its activity. Research like this could help us understand the evolution of our own Milky Way, which astronomers are confident has collided with many smaller galaxies before. Researchers have developed an ultra-thin pressure sensor that can be attached directly to the skin. It can measure how fingers interact with objects to produce useful data for medical and other applications. The sensor has minimal effect on the user's sensitivity and ability to grip objects, and it's resistant to disruption from rubbing. They are made from two distinct layers, both made by a process called electrospinning, which resembles a spider spinning its web. One layer is an insulating polyurethane mesh with fibers about 200 nanometers to 400 nanometers thick, about 1/500th the thickness of a human hair. The other layer is a stencil-like network of lines made from gold that form the functional electronic component of the sensor. Researcher Sung-Hoon Lee and his colleagues hope their sensor can be used for the novel task of digitally archiving the skills of craft workers.